Firstly, the poison ivy part, be it the leaf or stem, really needs to be broken or injured to release the inner held urushiol. The chemicals within the urushiol will seep into the skin. Alone, they are too small to elicit an immune response. But acting as haptens, they will bond to proteins within the skin, and then a dendritic cell, called a Langerhans cell, will grab onto the protein with the urushiol. This cell will be like, WTF, and will eventually get an antigen signal to the lymph nodes to recruit some helper T cells. This is like the cell dialing 911. If it is your first exposure to poison ivy, the T cells may ignore the situation, but remember the urushiol for the next time. Or the reaction may be really delayed, possibly for weeks. And in some people, the T cells will never react to the urushiol from poison ivy. But if the T cells decide this foreign invasion should be dealt with, they will release cytokines and chemokines, or proteins that send signals to other cells. This is what causes the itchiness and swelling. This signal is like the original arriving officer calling in the SWAT team, fire department, and ambulances as backup. They call in macrophages, which consume other cells, and they call in T lymphocytes that kill cells. They also call in more helper T cells. All of the cells are releasing signals to recruit more cells to deal with the urushiol invasion. T lymphocytes kill the Langerhans cell that grabbed the protein that had originally grabbed the urushiol. However, these T lymphocytes kind of go bonkers and start killing healthy cells as well. Basically, the skin turns into a little war zone, and the skin turns red and blisters, but it will heal and regenerate in time. Yes, so you won't be passing any biochem tests with that animation, but you get the gist. I don't know why I made the T lymphocytes so scary looking. Be sure to check out the full video where I rub poison ivy all over myself and test a few remedies to see what is best to alleviate that itching, and also what washes do best to just avoid getting the worst of the itch.